Hi there, Josh here today with Evergreen Tutorials, here to tell you about the YEARFRAC function in Excel 2016. The YEARFRAC function turns to us a difference of dates, and we're going to try it out right here. Equals YEARFRAC, left parenthesis, I'm going to put in today, comma, today plus 180, so 180 days in the future. Then it's going to ask us for a basis. Basically, it gives us a couple different systems that we can work with. So say we want to actual day count, 360, 365, 3060, whatever. I'm just going to go with the default zero. And you don't even have to put that in there. You just leave it as is. And we get about 0.5. So from today and 180 days in the future is about a half of a year's difference. The YEARFRAC function takes in several different inputs. So we'll say we have a formatted date, a serial number, a long date. These are actually all the today function. And down here we have a date without quotes, which you really want to avoid putting in. If you put this in without quotes, it'll see it as a date somewhere between January 1st, 1900 and in that general area. We'll just try it out here. Equals YEARFRAC today, comma, 12/25/2017, end, and we get 118.1, which is actually 118 years. So it does in fact put it back around January 1st 1900. So if you're ever putting in a date, make sure it's in quotes. And it also accepts any functions that return to you a formatted date, such as today or now or whatever. So over here, I have an example of the YEARFRAC function. So I'm just going to put in equals YEARFRAC. So what I want to do is set up a visual graph for how far away Jim Bob's birthday is. And I can do that with the YEARFRAC function. So I'm going to select my start date, which will be today, comma, Jim Bob's birthday. Right parenthesis, because I don't want to do anything fancy with it, enter, and I get 0.719. I know that 0.719 of a year are left. Now, to make that graph work with it, equals abs reference minus 1, enter, and now this pie chart will show me that about 3/4 of the year are left until Jim Bob's birthday. So I have a lot of time to prepare and make him his cake. Moving on over here, I'm going to explain the serial number real quick. So the serial number is the days after January 1st, 1900. So we get 43,137. That's how many days have passed since January 1st, 1900. Woohoo! I totally needed to know that today. And to the right of it is just the fractional part of the day. So when I change something in here, it'll actually update this. This is actually the now function. If we press enter off of that, it gives us a formatted date. So if you ever run into a date that looks horrendously formatted like that, you can format it as a date. And now it makes sense and it looks pretty. It should be noted that Excel will take any dates that you give it for this function and it will convert them to a serial number. So it'll convert them to that 43,137, and all the dates are worked with that. So if Excel needs to add 50 days to something, it will look at the serial number, add 50 to it, and then format it, and you will see the formatted date. You won't see the number behind it that it does math on. I'm Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and we went over the YEARFRAC function in Excel 2016. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. We'll try to get back to you. If you like this video, please subscribe. We have new videos daily. Thanks for watching. Bye.